We have made enough progress in science and are always yearning to do more. Scientists have been making research to accommodate the growing need of mankind. They have made considerable study in genetics to enhance the quality of livelihood, which is also measurable. Genes play a vital role not only in mankind but also in plants. Farmers have been making numerous varieties of a single breed. With the progress in gene studies, we know that genes decide the appearance and the characteristics of a living being. But if you go in depth into the study of genes, we will be able to distinguish the various functions of different kinds of genes which contribute to the overall appearance and characteristics of a living being. In this session, you will be introduced to two main kinds of genes, namely the reporter gene and the promoter gene. The former is used in plants so that the characteristics traits that the plant exhibits can be easily measured and supervised. The promoter is a region of DNA that initiates transcription of a particular gene. So, without any delay, with that small introduction on what we are going to see in the subsequent discussion, let us move forward to learn more. In molecular biology, a reporter gene, which is simply referred to as reporter, is a gene that scientists attribute to a regularity structure of a new gene of interest in bacteria, cell culture, animals or plants. Specific genes are selected as reporters since the individualities they report on entities expressing them are effortlessly identified and measured, otherwise for the reason that they are selectable markers. Reporter genes are usually used as a sign of whether a specific gene has been taken up by or expressed in the cell or entity population. To host a reporter gene into an organism, scientists place the reporter gene and the gene of interest in the same DNA make to be introduced into the cell or organism. This is usually in the form of a circular DNA molecule called plasmid for bacteria or prokaryotic cells in culture. It is essential to use a reporter gene that is not indigenously expressed in the cell or organism under study. This is because the expression of the reporter is being used as a marker for effective acceptance of the gene of interest. Normally used reporter genes, which bring usually distinguishable traits, commonly comprise fluorescent and luminescent proteins. Samples include the gene that encodes jellyfish green fluorescent protein called as GFP, which induce cells that express it to glow green in blue light. The luciferase enzyme, which catalyzes a response with the luciferin to produce light, and the red fluorescent protein from the gene DSRED. The GUS gene has been generally used in plants, but luciferase and GFP are pretty more common. The protein beta galactosidase is encoded by LACZ gene in E. coli, which is a regular reporter in bacteria. This enzyme makes bacteria expressing the gene to look blue when grown on a medium that has the substrate analog called X-GAL or X-GLUC. The chloramphenicol acetyltransferase gene or CAT gene is an example of a selectable marker which confers resistance to the antibiotic chloramphenicol is also a reporter in bacteria. Arabidopsis has close to 26,000 genes. A number of these genes are expressed most of the times in every cell. On the other hand, the majority of genes are only expressed in particular organs of the plant, either instigating that organ to be altered from other organs or adding role to that organ. Additionally, many genes are only expressed in specific progressive or environmental conditions in response to internal or external hints. Because the expression of genes is usually controlled by transcription, the promoter, which is a section of DNA prior to the coding region, will have the information that lets the gene to be turned on or off in various organs or in response to hints. Among some of the few plant promoters, the cauliflower mosaic virus 35S promoter, called as CAMB35S promoter, is expressed in almost every tissue all the times. This is called constitutively expressing promoters. Vital evidence to the function of a gene is to define where and when the gene is expressed. If it is expressed merely in flower stamens, then it is obvious that it has some part in male gamete formation or stamen growth. It is only expressed in specific conditions, such as after vulnerability to damaging UV light. It would be obvious that the gene has a part in reaching to such stress or healing. There are more than a few ways of defining where and when a specific gene is expressed in a plant. One way is to practice hybridization to discover the amount of mRNA of a cloned gene in testers from various portions of a plant and tested after various treatments of the plant. This method is measurable but is time consuming. Hence, alternative method is the use of a reporter gene. A reporter gene yields a protein that is detectable without difficulty in transformed organisms. Frequently, the protein has an enzymatic activity that can change a colorless substrate into a colored one. Therefore, one can understand the location and quantity of gene expression in a transformed organism by looking at the intensity and location of the colored product. Two examples of these reporter genes are the beta galactosidase LACZ gene and beta glucuronidase GUS gene. When the reporter gene is bonded to the promoter of the desired gene, the reporter gene will be expressed only at the times and locations wherever that gene is expressed as the promoter every so often determines transcription. This offers a technique to identify a very restricted expression of a gene. This can be seen such as in small patches of cells like root tips or pollen or at particular times, such as after a certain stress or hormone treatment. An essential property of the reporter gene is that their action is lacking in the organism in which they will be applied. Both LACZ and GUS are genes from Escherichia coli. Plants have some LACZ activity, and so it is tough to use it as a reporter gene for the reason that one does not know if the beta galactosidase discoloration is due to the hosted gene or the native plant gene. In dissimilarity, GUS activity is normally very little in plants and so is a regular reporter gene used in plant studies. Another technique of deciding a gene's function is to either transfigure it with the intention of not letting it to be expressed or cause it to be overexpressed. Overexpression of the gene always deals fewer problems. The coding region of the gene is attached to the constitutive CAMB35S promoter by controlling the DNA sequences in E. coli. We can host these DNA construct into Arabidopsis through Agrobacterium and expect for a modification in the phenotype of the plant. A changed phenotype should be an outcome of overexpression of the gene and so should be associated to the function of the gene. Overall, reporter genes are preferred to be genes whose expression can be easily supervised. That is to say that the expression should be effortlessly measured. There should be a smallest possible background and there should be little intrusion from other genes that can be expressed by the cell. At present, the most common reporter genes that are applied are luciferase and chloramphenicol acetyltransferase or CAT. CAT is the abbreviated form. It should not to be confused with the choline acetyltransferase, which is the gene that is responsible for the synthesis of the neurotransmitter acetylcholine. This gene is abbreviated as CAT or CHAT. Luciferase is a gene at first secluded from the firefly that in the incidence of luciferin and ATP releases photon and manufacture of photons can simply be observed by a glittering stand specifically designed for this purpose. Chloramphenicol acetyltransferase is selected since it is a bacterial gene that is not expressed in vertebrate cells. It too can be supervised since it can acetylate chloramphenicol. The acetylated chloramphenicol can be detached from unacetylated chloramphenicol by TLC, that is thin layer liquid chromatography, and identified by the existence of label present in chloramphenicol. There is basically no related level of activity in eukaryotic cells with this test, so it can be very sensitive. Both of these reporters have the benefit that they be influenced by the activity of a protein which is translated from a mRNA and consequently the translational process intensifies the sign. It is also likely to measure RNA transcription in a straight line by using an examination that uses either RNA's protection or northern analysis to observe mRNA levels. In some circumstances where the supervisory components lie within the coding regions of the gene that is being studied, it is usually essential to use a great portion of the coding sequence of the gene to understand transcriptional regulation. In these circumstances, hosting some sort of a marker into the reporter gene that lets it to be picked out from the endogenous gene can let measurement of the transcriptional activity. Let us say it is possible to use a duplicate of an endogenous coding region that is changed by the addition or deletion of a limited portion or the integration of a new controlled site. This approach has the benefit that it is often likely to be a holistic measure of the endogenous gene and the reporter gene, which offers an extra control in the study of regulated transcriptional happenings. Several approaches of transfection and transformation, two means of expressing a foreign or altered gene in an organism, are operative in only a small portion of a population exposed to the methods. As a result, a method for recognizing those few positive gene uptake events is essential. Reporter genes used in this method are usually expressed under their own promoter, self-governing from that of the hosted gene of interest. The reporter gene can be expressed with a peripheral intrusion such as the introduction of IPTG, that is isopropyl D-diogalactopyranoside, in the beta-galactosidase system. Consequently, the reporter gene's expression is independent of the desired gene expression, which is a plus. when the gene of interest is only expressed under particular specific conditions or in tissues that are challenging to contract. In the instance of selectable marker, reporters like CAT, the transfected population of bacteria can be developed on a substrate that has chloramphenicol. Only individual cells that have effectively adopted the construct having the CAT gene will endure and increase under these conditions. Reporter genes can also be used to examine the expression of the gene of interest, which may create a protein that has slightly apparent or instant influence on the cell culture or organism. In these circumstances, the reporter is openly attached to the gene of interest to build a gene fusion. The two genes are under the same promoter components and are copied into a single messenger RNA molecule. The mRNA is then interpreted into protein. In these cases, it is essential that both proteins be capable of properly folding into their active forms and also interacts with their substrates in spite of being fused. In producing the DNA construct, a segment of DNA coding for a malleable polypeptide linker region is generally involved with the purpose that the reporter and the gene product will only negligibly interfere with one another. In genetics, a promoter is a region of DNA that starts transcription of a specific gene. Promoters are situated close to the genes they transcribe, upstream of the template strand or non-coding strand. Promoters can be about 100 to 1000 base pairs long. Reporter genes can be used to examine the activity of a specific promoter in a cell or organism. In this example, there is no discrete gene of interest. The reporter gene is merely positioned under the mechanism of the target promoter. The reporter gene product's action is quantitatively measured. The outcomes are usually stated relative to the action under a consensus promoter known to persuade robust gene expression. For the transcription to have effect, the enzyme that produces RNA, known as RNA polymerase, must attribute to the DNA close to a gene. Promoters have particular DNA sequences and reaction components that offer a safe early binding site for RNA polymerase and for proteins termed as transcription factors that employ RNA polymerase. These transcription elements have exact activator or repressor in sequences of resultant nucleotides that fashion to particular promoters and control gene expression. The promoter is identified by RNA polymerase and its sigma element, which is helped by an activator protein's binding to its own adjacent DNA binding site. The procedure is more challenging, and as a minimum, 7 various factors are essential for the binding of an RNA polymerase to the promoter. Promoters characterize serious components that can labor in concert with other controlling regions such as enhancers, silencers, boundary elements or insulators to direct the level of transcription of a certain gene. The RNA polymerase II core promoter is a crucial component in the regulation of gene expression. The growth, development and existence of eukaryotic organisms need the suitable regulation of tens of thousands of genes by complex formulae that have so far not been cracked. The expression of each of these thousands of genes is organized by extensive variety of mechanisms. In this session, we will review and focus on one of these regulatory components, the RNA polymerase II core promoter. Now, let us to begin with analyze why we need to understand the core promoter. First, the study of core promoters adds major understandings into the mechanisms by which transcription take place in eukaryotes. This simple information is part of the basis of our molecular understanding of biology. Second, the flow of events that go before the activation of transcription must ultimately lead to the primary transcriptional technology at the core promoter. In this way, the core promoter is the final objective of action of all of the elements that are tangled in the regulation of transcription by RNA polymerase II. So, what is a core promoter? We can define the core promoter as the least expanse of adjacent DNA sequence that is adequate to direct precise beginning of transcription by the RNA polymerase II. Characteristically, the core promoter includes the site of transcription beginning and extends either upstream or downstream for an additional more or less 35 nucleotides. As a result, in many cases, the core promoter will include only about 40 nucleotides. There are quite a lot of sequence ideas consist of the Tata box, initiator or INR, TF2B, transcription factor 2B, recognition element, simply called as BRE, and downstream core promoter component, DPE, that are usually found in core promoters. These ideas each have particular functions that relate to the transcription method, and we'll be discussing it now in higher aspect. It is vital to note that each of these core promoter components is found in certain but not all core promoters. For example, it is a common misunderstanding that all core promoters contain a Tata box. It looks as if that there are no worldwide core promoter components. The principal promoter is the location of action of the RNA polymerase II transcriptional machinery. RNA polymerase II is a multi-subunit enzyme that catalyzes the production of mRNA from the DNA template. Precise and well-organized transcription from one core promoter needs the polymerase beside the auxiliary factors that are usually termed as basal or general transcription factors, which comprise transcription factor TF, simply called as TF2A, TF2B, TF2D, TF2E, TF2F and TF2H. It has been found that with the Tata box dependent core promoters, the filtered factors can gather into a transcription pre-initiation complex, that is called PIC PIC, in the subsequent order, TF2D, TF2B, RNA polymerase II, TF2F complex, TF2E and then TF2H. There are several TBP, Tata binding protein containing complexes, and therefore the TAFs that are associated in RNA polymerase II transcription are labeled TAF2-250, TAF2-150 and so on. The TAF nomenclature has been reviewed recently. TF2B is a single polypeptide that networks with the TBP in addition to the DNA upstream of the Tata box. In the step-by-step PIC assembly mechanism, TF2D and TF2B are the first two elements that network with the core promoter. As a result, it looks as if these two elements have a serious part in the acknowledgement of core promoter motifs. The recognition of core promoter specific enhancers specifies the significance of learning transcriptional enhancers in combination with their associated core promoters. For example, if a DPE downstream core promoter element specific enhancer were merged to a TATA dependent core promoter, then transcriptional stimulation would not be witnessed. The developing image of transcriptional regulation is one of the unexpected diversity and difficulty. Even though our understanding of eukaryotic gene regulation has advanced noticeably, the unbelievable complexity of the system has become obvious. In this session, we discussed the reporter genes and promoters. We also discussed the functions of reporter genes and promoters. A reporter gene is a gene that scientists assign to a regulatory sequence of another gene of interest. In bacteria, cell culture, animals or plants, specific genes are selected as reporters because the individualities they impart on beings expressing them are easily recognized and evaluated. Transcriptional enhancers are challenged with an extensive range of core promoters. Core promoters not only channelize the initiation of transcription, but also partake in the specificity of enhancer function. Core promoters are considerably much more than simple DNA frameworks for the basal transcription machinery. Relatively, core promoter elements are energetic and vital contributors in the regulation of